Pelosi has another stutter moment, forgets who won vote. House Minority Leader Nancy Pelosi has referred to herself within the past year as a master legislator and indispensable head of the Democrat Party, even as she has become increasingly forgetful about aspects of her job or the reality of the world around her. Recall that on multiple occasions within the past year, Pelosi has seemingly forgotten that President Donald Trump won the election, referring to him as former President George W. Bush several times and even mentioning former President Barack Obama's name when speaking of Trump. The leader just had another Pelosi moment once again when she appeared to have forgotten not only a significant vote the Democrat caucus held on a prestigious committee position, but who won that vote as well. Watch as Pelosi stumbles and stutters and needs prodding to explain who won the caucus vote to replace disgraced Representative John Conyers as the ranking member of the all-important House Judiciary Committee, courtesy of the GOP war room, who probably couldn't help but laugh at the bumbling of their opposition's top person. Pelosi seemingly needed to be reminded that the caucus just held a vote on the powerful position, and further reminded, including with a slip of paper, that New York Representative Jerry Nadler had been chosen for the role. According to The Intercept, Democrats had to choose between Nadler of New York City and California Representative Zoe Lofgren of the Silicon Valley area to become the next ranking member of the Judiciary Committee. Both candidates are considered quite progressive in their views, which could present a problem for Republicans and President Trump should Democrats regain control of the House, and thus, control of the committees. The leader of the Judiciary Committee gets to set the agenda when it comes to such issues as gun control, immigration policy, law enforcement oversight and surveillance capabilities. That committee would also be where impeachment proceedings against a sitting president would be started as well. According to Politico, Nadler defeated Lofgren by a vote of 118-72 on Wednesday. It is notable that Nadler held an edge on his opponent going into the vote as he has served on the committee for 25 years already, and was serving as acting ranking member over the duration since Conyers stepped down in disgrace. This is a pivotal time, with our country possibly on the verge of a constitutional crisis, Nadler reportedly stated to the caucus prior to the vote. We cannot afford to make this choice based on anything but who is the best person to sit in that chair. Incredibly, despite their lofty rhetoric and constant needling of Republicans on social justice issues, it should be pointed out that Democrats just picked an old white guy over a woman for a powerful position. Lofgren would have been the first woman in that role in the committee's 200-plus year history, but we digress. It is also noteworthy that Nadler refused to commit to pursuing an impeachment against Trump if Democrats should regain control of the House following the midterms, as he knows doing so would require cooperation and support from Republicans, and he recalled how the last attempt at an impeachment ended up dying in the Senate. There's not much point in impeaching a president and having him acquitted in the Senate, as happened fought with former President Bill Clinton, Nadler had stated during a recent interview when the topic of potentially ousting Trump came up. As for the gaffe-prone Ms. Pelosi, given she couldn't even recall what vote had just been held prior to Wednesday's news conference or who had won it, she may not even recall the attempted impeachment of Clinton or why some Democrats are pushing to impeach Trump.